Chapter number 9 of your NCERT, that is Living Organisms and Their Surroundings. We all know that we are surrounded by some objects. So some are living and some are non-living. Both, what is the common in them is that they are made up of matter. Now, what is environment? Everything surrounding and affecting an organism is known as its environment. Right. See, living things are organisms live everywhere on this earth. They live deep inside the ocean where no light reaches and it is totally dark. They also live in the high mountains which are always covered with snow, like your polar bears, your penguins. They live all around your house and also inside your house, like your pets, your dogs, animals. Several organisms even live inside your bodies too. We have some kind of bacteria and everything inside our body. These are also the organisms. So plants and animals living in different places are different from each other. They adapt themselves to their surroundings. Let's suppose if I take an example of polar bear. Now polar bears are a winter animal. They cannot stay on the bare land where there is no snow. They are snow animals. They can live only where there is a snow and where the temperature is very low. Whereas if I talk about fishes, they cannot live on the land. They live in the water itself. So plants and animals living in different places are different from each other, and they adapt themselves to their surroundings. Living things do not live in isolation. All organisms, both plants and animals, need food and other material from their surroundings to survive. I've told you in the very first video we made of the first chapter, we learned about the food cycle or the food chain, which means every organism is dependent on one another for their food. We human beings are dependent on the animals and plants for the food. Plants are the producers. Animals again are the consumers, as they depend upon the plants or the human beings for their food or each other. Now, this was environment. Now, what is ecology? The other term is the study of the relationship between living things and their environment is called ecology. Now see, what is ecology? Whenever we study the relationship between the living things and their environment in which they live and in which they survive, is called ecology. See, an environment is made up of two types of components, that is living and non-living components. Living components need food, need air to survive, whereas non-living components are made up of matter and they do not breathe, they do not need food for anything. All of them interact with each other. So in this video, we've studied about what are the organisms, environment, ecology. I hope you've understood this. Do download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.